various locations. We also know that fireworks were deployed at some of the locations. We're still piecing a lot of this together. Ultimately, I can follow up with you via email. Ultimately, I think about 67 tickets were issued. We used tire deflation devices on several vehicles that were eluding the area. And I know several vehicles were towed. I'm doing it off the top of my head. I can follow up with you about it with an email regarding the exact numbers. Arrests, I'm not sure on. I know the tickets were issued. I think 67 tickets. This has been an ongoing issue in Kansas City, and we've tried all kinds of stuff to address it, and last night we addressed it with some enforcement.
What is your emotional response, sir, to the fact that, you know, some of these, where the shooting was reported, there was a youth baseball game happening that was underway at the time?
So, again, we're still investigating that, whether or not that was fireworks or actual shots being fired. We're still looking into that. We do know that shots were fired at some of these locations. Emotionally, I'm not sure. Look, anytime people fire off guns in the city limits, we should all be emotional about that. The entire city needs to really be emotional about that and say, this is not the city that we're going to have. And so it's disappointing to bring that to our city, I would say.
And then just my last question, sir, is that rocks also being thrown at some of these officers that was reported? What kind of damage could that have done?
Yes. Off of one of our overpasses on the highway, there are reports of bricks being thrown off and striking vehicle. No one was injured. I don't know the extent of the damage on the cars.
Now, I know that we saw some video and some of it involved stuff happening near Johnny's Tavern, that area. I mean, a lot of those folks, I was able to speak with them, a lot of them were concerned about the activity that occurred and their vehicles possibly being hit and whatnot. What would be your message to business owners down there?
So, I guess, let me take the first part of what you said. We try to have this balance, right? I think that people are concerned. They see cars driving like maniacs. I mean, let's face it. We've all seen the video. These people are driving in a way that is so selfish that they don't realize that they are sharing these streets with the rest of the city and that these streets are here for law-abiding citizens to use and for commerce to happen. This is... We don't pave these and pay for these for you to spin your tires on them. That's not what they're here for. So that's the first part. The second part of that is that the police try to balance what is the safest way to get these folks in custody. And I don't think that chasing these cars through the streets makes it safer, right? So we try to balance that. We were able to use tire deflation devices in this incident or tow the vehicles if they meet that criteria. For the people that are concerned, I would say we are working on this. We are, like I said earlier, we've tried a multitude of response options to this. These are not, this is not just some fun thing that kids are doing on the weekend. These are violent encounters, and they are, this is not the look I don't think that we want for our city.
Some people are saying,
well, I would say that anybody that wants to go on camera or whatever, if anybody wants to advocate in favor of spinning your tires in the middle of the street and shooting your gun off, if anybody wants to go advocate for that, they're free to do that. It's our job to make sure that those types of dangerous things don't happen. And like I said, the tire deflation devices are one of our options that we have to safely stop this. I understand the question, obviously, and I know that there are people that these have been going on for months. There are a lot of people who think that this is totally just fine. We don't. And I know that our partners in the city and our community groups and the people that are having dinner at Johnny's, they don't. People that are playing baseball games where people are shooting guns off, they don't. So I understand the question. I know what you're saying. I just don't agree with that.
Captain Johnson, has the leadership from the department met this morning to discuss the response that happened last night? And if so, how effective has the leadership determined that response to have been?
I think time will tell. It just happened last night. I hope it was effective. Like, I know that you just got here, but we have tried all kinds of options so far. We're still in the process of working with some of our partners to maybe put some ordinances in place that give us a little bit more teeth. I know that there are some state laws that are also in play here, but I certainly hope it was effective. I hope that this curbs this behavior.
I don't want to mischaracterize what you said, but what I got from it is you're saying that it's reckless, it's stupid, and you guys are going to prosecute to the fullest extent of the law. The people that are doing this.
Well, I think it's illegal, and to put the adjectives to it, I think it is dangerous, and I think that's why there are ordinances against it, and that's what we enforced last night.
And now, we've seen sideshows like these across the country and other cities. Does it seem strange with the level of violence that seems to be attached with some of the sideshows that we've seen here, or is that kind of normal?
I'll say this. I can't think of any reason why violence would go with these things. I can't think of any reason why we're shooting guns off in the city. I can't think of any good reason. I know I talked to one of you guys last night about our weekly shoot reviews, and we've been doing those for over a year now. I go to every single one every week, and I am rarely impressed with the reason that we come up with why we're shooting each other. Rarely impressed.
Do you feel like it would be less violent if these people had a place to go?
I think that's an interesting solution, and I know that that's been talked about. And I know that that's even come up. I think that there have been some places. There are some aggravating factors to that, too, as far as some of these side issues that end up popping up in this. And I understand why people wouldn't necessarily want to open their place up to that, too. But that has been something that's been brought up.
What advice do you have for people that are stuck in traffic caused by
this? You know, I don't have a great answer to that. If you can drive around, that would be one thing. Call 911 is probably your best bet, is to call 911 and make sure that we're aware. Last night, I know they're in several locations, so the police may just not be aware of where it's occurring, so please call 911.
Captain, as the cars are doing donuts, are shots being fired from within the car, kind of like a Russian roulette, whoever's standing around?
You know, I can't classify that. I haven't really seen the video. Sometimes, I don't know if they're emanate from the car or in the crowd as fights break out. I just don't know the answer to that. And I suspect that it's probably different in each circumstance.
As weather gets warmer, are you prepared for more incidents like this?
You know, I certainly hope not. We are absolutely prepared. We have the officers that are on the street. We have been talking about this for weeks. Internally and with our partners, there are some, like I said at the beginning, there's a lot of ways that we've tried to address this. This is another way. We'll keep working through it.
Any special units being developed in light of this?
We have units that already address traffic issues, and they're taking the lead on this.
Are there any additional, I know when you're talking about rocks being thrown off of a bridge, I mean, that can be fatal. Do you mind just describing kind of the consequences of that action as well?
You're right. We did a celebratory gunfire thing right before the Super Bowl. And whether it's shooting a gun off, whether it's throwing rocks off of overpasses or bricks off of overpasses, whether it's spinning a car out of control or racing down the streets, these are very reckless things that people die from in Kansas City, Missouri. And we want to see it stop. I mean, there are a lot of things that happen in this city that we'd like to address our attention to and focus on other than violent crime and people spinning their tires.
Any motive thoughts as to all of this?
I don't know. I will tell you that I have spoken to one of the coordinators of this myself, and And the answer, the overwhelming answer is that this is fun. This is fun.
So thinking about, you know, financial consequences, how much does it cost to get your car out of the impound lot? Or, you know, how much are the fines for these tickets?
Yeah, the maximum fine will be $500. Getting your tow out of the car out of the tow lot kind of depends on how long it's there. The tickets would range again, up to about $500. So I don't know the exact tickets that people were written.
Were any bystanders or law enforcement officers injured in any of this?
I don't think there was any injuries last night, which, I think that's a testament with that many cars firing shots and eluding. For the police that responded to this and were able to get it squelched, able to get it disbanded, and able to get it under control without anybody being injured, I think is a testament to the leadership and the actions of the officers that were there. I don't know the answer to that. I didn't know anyone was hit. I don't know the answer to that.
This is partly fueled by social media. These people do it for the likes, for the shares, the views. How often are you guys trying to keep your analysts ahead of it? Are you guys monitoring actively the social media, trying to figure out where they may pop up next? I'm assuming that the beautiful weather last night, there was noise and gathering. So going into the spring and summer months, are your analysts working to get ahead of this?
Correct. Yes, I'll just say that yes, we are. Yes, yes, we do monitor, and yes, the answer to your question is yes, we do watch it.
Do you know which racing groups were involved in all this last night?
I don't.
So along with the nice weather, there's been a bunch of four wheelers and other off roading vehicles on the streets in the parks. Can you explain how? Is that illegal and what are the consequences?
Yes, there are specific. I would have to follow up with you exactly. But yes, some of these, you have to have a light, you have to have headlights. There are some certain restrictions. You can't just drive your four-wheelers around. Driver's license, you have to have a driver's license. You have to have all of that to operate on the street. You're right. If you need specifics, I'll get it to you.
How are the investigations going into the shooting so far?
Just starting, and I know that you mentioned that there were a couple of people shot. I know that that's happened, but I don't know where or what circumstances on that, so I can follow up with you.
Thank you.